Friends, welcome back to Best Ready Study. In this video, let's see most important questions for intermediate second year civics. Now let's begin our video. Coming to the first chapter, which is Indian Constitution and Historical Context. From this chapter, coming to 10 marks, there are two most important questions. One is, explain the features of Indian Constitution. Second question is, what are the different phases of Indian national movement? Okay. So, coming to 5 marks questions, you will be asked, what are the provisions of the Government of Indian Act 1919? Okay, 1919. Okay, important. And explain the causes of the birth in Indian national movement. Important question. And explain the home rule movement. Important question. Okay. So coming to 2 marks, they'll ask you what is Indian Constitution. Make sure you learn the definition of it, and they'll ask you what is method of extremists and what is constituent assembly, very important, and they'll ask you what is meant by drafting committee. Okay, so coming to second chapter, which is fundamental rights and directive principles. Coming to long answers, you'll be asked what are the principles of the state policy, very important question, and you'll be asked what are the fundamental rights which are incorporated in Indian Constitution. Okay, so coming to short questions, that is 5 marks questions from this chapter, you'll be asked what are the different differences you found in between the fundamental rights and directive principles, important question, and what are the principles of state policy. And they'll ask you what are the liberal intellectual principles, important question. Okay, so coming to 2 marks, they'll ask you what is right to equality, right to freedom, and what is 4 different fundamental duties of the citizen, important question. And coming to next chapter, which is union government, for 10 marks, they'll be asking you questions such as, describe the powers of Prime Minister of India, very important question. And they'll ask you, describe ordinary and emergency powers of President of India, important. And coming to short answers from this Union Government chapter, they'll be asking you what is emergency powers of President of India, and this question will be asked as a long as well as short sometimes. Okay, so make sure you read this answer, question and answer very well. Okay, and what are the functions of the High Court, and what is the judicial review of the Supreme Court, this will be asked for short answer. Okay, so coming to 2 marks, they'll ask you how is President removed, and what is national emergency, what is legislative power of President, important question, what is judicial review, important, and what are the 3 functions or what are the 5 functions of High Court. Generally for 2 marks answer, they'll ask you just 2 to 3 functions of the High Court. Okay, if it is 5, for 5 marks they'll ask you to elaborate the answer, to give more functions. Okay, so coming to next chapter, which is state government, they'll ask you for long, they'll ask you write about the powers and functions of state governor, and they'll ask you what are the powers of chief minister, or what are the rights and responsibilities of chief minister, important. And coming to 5 marks, they'll ask you what is the structure of state legislative council, important question, and explain the difference between unions and states. Okay, for 2 marks they may ask you any question from this chapter. They'll ask you what is legislative assembly, what is legislative council, what is state executive, what is who is assembly speaker, what are the roles and responsibilities of the assembly speaker, any question they may ask you, and what is union list and all. Okay, so coming to next chapter, which is local governments, they'll ask you for only 5 and 2 marks. They'll not ask you for 10 marks from this particular chapter. Okay, so coming to 5 marks, they'll ask you what is the background of local governments of India, and what are the main provisions of constitution, such as 73rd Amendment Act or 74th Amendment Act. They may ask you anything. Okay, and They'll ask you for 2 marks, such as what is Gram Sabha, what is Jilla Parishad, what is Municipal Corporation, what are municipalities and responsibilities of them, and all for 2 marks. Okay. So coming to Special Statutory Commission from this particular chapter, for 5 marks they'll ask you what are the powers and functions of National Commission Human Rights, National Commission Scheduled Caste. They may ask you any question, okay, from this particular National Commission. Okay, for 2 marks they'll ask you what are Human Rights Commission, what are the responsibilities of Human Rights Commission, and what are she teams, and who are monitors, who are district consumer forums, all this very important. Okay, so coming to next chapter, which is social and political movements, from this they'll be asking you 10 marks question, and one of the most important long answer question from this particular chapter is explain the causes and consequences of Telangana peasant armed struggle. Very important question. Okay, so coming to 5 marks question from this particular chapter, they'll ask you what is the Dalit movement in Telangana, what are the environmental struggles in Telangana, and all. Okay, and who are the strugglers of Telangana, all these questions. So coming to emergence of Telangana state, from this they'll ask you 10 marks, 5 marks as well as 2 marks questions. Coming to 10 marks, they'll ask you discuss the formation of Telangana, very important question. And coming to 5 marks, they'll ask you what is the provision of gentleman's agreement, what is the note of Telangana movement 1969, and all. So coming to 2 marks, they'll ask you what is Hyderabad state, what is Telangana movement, and all, which is important. And yeah, coming to smart governance, from this particular chapter, they'll be asking you 5 marks as well as 2 marks questions. Coming to 5 marks, they'll ask you what is e-governance, what are the merits and demerits of it, and what is smart governance, what is the rights of information act, and all. So coming to 2 marks, they'll ask you what is the government to citizens, what is the rule of government, what are the objectives of the smart city, and all important. So coming to these particular civics, whatever I told you, those are one of few of the important questions. Make sure you concentrate on them. So thank you for watching this video till the end. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, because I'll be doing more and more such videos on other subjects as well. So subscribe, hit the bell icon, like and share this video with all your friends. And if you have any doubts or any queries regarding anything, you can comment in the comment section below so that I'll reply you, right? Okay. Yeah, thanks for watching. All the very best for your exam, and yeah, bye.